With less than 3 weeks until the general election, KHON2 will host the Honolulu mayoral debate tonight. So what should voters be looking for, and what will this race all boil down to? Political analyst and HPU communication professor John Hart joins us now with his thoughts. Good morning to you, Dr. Hart. Thanks again for joining us.
Thank you.
So we're talking about Amemiya and Blangiardi. Neither of them have political experience. So what should voters be looking for?
Well, I would hope we would continue to see more evidence of what either one of them would actually do when they're in office. So far, what we know is Blangiardi will hire good people to figure out what to do. And Amemiya is a Democrat. I hope we find out more so we can make an informed decision.
And that was my next question. Basically, what's been missing? So for you, what's been missing is just answers, a detailed plan on how we're all going to move forward.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, if Blangiardi says he's going to hire good people, why hasn't he consulted them now so he can tell us more about what he's going to do? And for Amemiya, other than being a Democrat, again, what are you going to do? Neither one of these people have a track record we can look at, so people start looking at other things like, do I like him or is he strong? And those are difficult things to make a decision on.
What about in the weeks to come? We're less than 3 weeks away. I've already seen punches being thrown, attacks being made. Are we going to see even more in the next 3 weeks?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I would argue that the KHON debate is pivotal. Blangiardi finished first in the primary by a significant margin. Despite a good social media campaign, Amemiya does not appear to have closed that gap. So he needs to win this debate, not only on points, he needs to win it significantly. He needs to do something in this debate to turn it around. He needs the win, a push, a tie, close, win on points, all of those go to Blangiardi. Amemiya needs to win this debate. He needs to win it decisively. It is a pivotal moment in the campaign.
But in your opinion, how do you do that? Is it all about personal attacks? Do those personal attacks ever really prove to be victorious, or do you more focus on yourself and what you plan to do instead of pointing the finger at someone else?
Well, you know, voters always say they don't like negative advertising, they don't like negative campaigning, but when we study it, it seems to work. Yeah, I would think Amemiya needs to go even more on the defensive. He needs to do something in this debate to turn this one around.
All right, sounds great. Dr. John Hart, political analyst and also HPU communication professor, thank you so much for joining us with your thoughts. Nice to see you.
Be safe.
You too.